your questioning of Mr. Stevens, the transcript indicates a 29-page transcript of questions between yourself, the other detective that was present, and Mr. Stevens. At any time during that questioning, did he ever ask for a break?
Not that I recall.
Did he ever indicate to you that he was having problems remembering or understanding, remembering facts in the course of your question?
I would have to review it, not that I recall offhand right now. If it's possible, if I could review back to the statement.
I think we have a copy if we want to get to.
There is a portion that I've just come upon on page 6 where he stated that he didn't remember the answer to the question.
What was the question?
Line 15, I asked him, so before, reading from the transcript, okay, so before getting to Bordentown, where do you guys go? Do you remember? Mr. Stevens responds, I don't remember that.
What about page 14? Can you look at page 14?
Yes. On line 10, Mr. Stevens responded that he didn't remember in a fact.
What was the question that led to that answer?
On line 9, reading from the transcript, I asked Mr. Stevens what happens next.
Next, in relation to what? Do you recall?
Judge, I'm going to object now. We're just literally reading testimony
into
the record.
I'm going to overrule it. You can answer the question.
What was the question answered?
His answer that he didn't remember was in relation to what question?
Back to the previous page, my question starts on line 25, says, okay, so what, tell me about the conversation when you get in there. And then Mr. Stevens says, it was basically like, I can quit right now, you know, I can leave, drop this and leave. He was saying some stuff like that. And basically, that was what, you know, I don't have to go with this load or something. I could just leave this load, you know. And then there was an indiscernible audio clip there where the transcript could not be read. And then it picks up again the content. That's how the conversation was. And then my question to Mr. Stevens was, okay, what happens next? And to that, Mr. Stevens responded, I don't even remember how, or I don't even remember how, I just don't remember how. All I remember now is him coming at me, swinging in there with that knife.
Mr. Stevens on July 16th, at some point in time he indicated to you that he lost his keys.
Yes.
Did he mention his keys in his first statement?
I don't recall him saying that.
To your knowledge, did he ever indicate to anyone how he believes he lost his keys?
Not that I'm aware of.
No, no other questions?
Ms. Hutchinson.
Page 2, on line 2, I indicate the date is November 13, 2018, and I indicated the time was 9:24 a.m.
And then on page 29, at the end, you indicate you concluded at 9:55, is that right?
Yes, on line 1, page 29, it indicates 9:55.
Okay, so it was about 30 minutes or so, give or take.
Yes.
And was the goal of the statement to stay in there forever, belaboring the point, or just get the facts from the victim?
Objection.
Overruled.
Or was it to sit in there and belabor what happened that day, or to get the facts from the victim?
Try and ascertain the facts from the victim.
Do you normally stay in hospitals for long periods of time with victims when taking statements?
Objection.
I'll sustain that.
I just have one moment, just
sure.
I have no further questions here.
There's some shocking further questions.
During that half hour interval when the statement was being taken, did you have any breaks?
Not that I recall, no.
And he was discharged on November 15th, 2 days later.